We praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
I'm going to now go right into the word that I received from the Lord to give to you this day. Amen. But perhaps you'll give it to me. This word here is something else. Amen. I said, you know, we went to Panama, we had a team, and I'm stuck on that team to God. Be thou worthy. Amen? Now, great things he has done. And I'm hoping and praying that tonight, the glory of God will pass over this house. Amen?
Amen.
I'm just going to pray on peace and music. Father, to you do I come this hour in weakness and humbleness, Father God. You are a glorious God, a magnificent God, an awesome God. You are the God of our salvation. You are the God who makes the difference in our lives. You are the God who lifts us up when we fall down. You are the Lord who takes us to the next level. And tonight, Father, I come to you. Asking a deep of God to just open my intellect. Give me, Lord God, the strength to do what you have asked to do here tonight. Father, dear God, I hope and pray that those who are in the house at this very hour, Father God, who are going to hear my voice, that you will touch their heart this morning, Father God, and that you will give them, dear Lord, what they are seeking tonight. That will be the blessing of the Lord. Amen. Father God, today I thank you, I glorify you, I lift up your name, I give you praise this hour in Jesus' name. Amen. We praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
I'm going to be reading from Exodus, the 20th chapter. It says, and God spake all these words, saying, I am the Lord thy God, which hath brought thee out of the land of Egypt, out of the house of bondage. Thou shalt have no other God before me. Thou shalt not make unto thee any graven images, or any likeness of anything that is in heaven above, or that is in the earth beneath, or that is in the waters under the earth. Thou shalt not bow down thyself to them, nor serve them, for I, the Lord thy God, am jealous, I'm a jealous God, visiting the iniquity of the fathers upon the children, unto the third and fourth generation of them that hate me. We praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
And I'm going to go right over to where the commandments are. It says, thou shalt not have any other God before me. Thou shalt not make unto thee graven images or likeness of anything that is in the world. Thou shalt not bow down thyself to them. And the third one, thou shalt not take the name of the Lord thy God in vain. For the Lord will not hold him guiltless that taketh his name in vain. Fourth one says, remember the Sabbath day to keep it holy. 6 days shall thou labor and do all thy work. But the seventh day is the Sabbath of the Lord thy God. In it thou shalt not do any work, thou, nor thy sons, nor thy daughters, nor thy servants, nor the maidservants, nor cattle, nor thy strangers that is within thy gate. For in 6 days the Lord made heaven and earth, the sea and all that in them is, and rested at the seventh day. Wherefore the Lord blessed the Sabbath day and hallowed it. Honor thy father and thy mother, that thy days may be longer upon the land which the Lord thy God giveth thee. Thou shalt not kill. Thou shalt not commit adultery. Thou shalt not steal. Thou shalt not bear false witness against thy neighbor. And the 10th one, thou shalt not covet thy neighbor's house. Thou shalt not covet thy neighbor's wife, nor his manservant, nor his maidservant, nor his ox, nor his ass, nor us protecting, we praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Go on, go on.
Make him, make something complete, free from fault or defect, or as close to such condition as possible, or perfect being without fault or defect, meaning being complete. We praise God.
Praise the Lord.
Sufficiency. Sufficiency, a sufficient quality to meet one's need, the condition or quality of being adequate or sufficient. You praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Perfecting to the sufficiency of God. Amen. Matthew 5:48 says, "Be ye not therefore perfect, even as your Father which is in heaven is perfect." Matthew 19:21 says, Jesus said unto him, "If thou shalt be perfect, and boasted that thou all that thou hast, and give to the poor, thou shalt have treasure in heaven. And come and follow me." We praise God.
Praise the Lord.
Perfect him.
Yeah.
Thou shalt sell. Amen. All that you have, you shall give it away, give it all. And it says then, once you do that, amen? Then you will have treasures in heaven. And he didn't only stop there, but he continued to go on and say, and come, follow me.
Yes.
So we have a few things that we have to put in perspective, amen? Before we decide to follow God.
Go on.
Now, I believe that as we begin to perfect ourselves, the scripture is saying here that we begin by letting go of those things that we love. We begin by giving them away. We got them in the world. We give them back to the world. Amen?
Yeah.
And once we do that, the baggage that we usually walk with becomes a little lighter. Then we are light enough to begin to receive perfection as we move on in Christ. Amen? Why I read the Ten Commandments verse is because I'm going to actually begin to speak to you in regards to sin. Because the biggest problem that we have to begin to walk that perfect walk is holding on to sin. We praise God.
Praise the Lord.
So we have to let go of those things that would easily beset us. Amen?
Amen.
So I wanted you just to emphasize to you the things that were said to the Israelites in the Old Testament, the laws that were given to them, which were only 10, and they still could not follow those 10 commandments in order to begin to walk in perfection. And why they could not follow them, because why I say that is because if you notice, every time they had a feast, every time they had something that they had to do, every time they had that moment when they had to carry their dove, their lamb, their goat, their and take blood to the altar just to come and wash.
Yeah.
But they continue to go back and do the same thing. And I say to you tonight, if we are walking towards perfection in Christ, then we need to stop doing the same mistake over and over again. Amen?
Amen.
Speak on it.
So tonight, I'm going to really emphasize on sin. Because sin is the one problem that we all have as Christians. And because we know that Jesus Christ came, died on the cross, if we go exact mistake over and over again. And we are walking towards perfection in the sufficiency of God. Amen? And tonight, I want you to just turn to your neighbor right now and say to them, your neighbor, I am letting go of sin. We praise God. I am letting go of sin. Amen?
Amen.
We praise the Lord. It came from your mom, right? 1 Peter, 2 chapter 22 and 23 says, he declared he did not sin, neither was God found in his mouth. He declared, I'm sorry, who did not mean it? There was a who did not, who did not sin, amen? Neither was God found in his mouth. Who, again, when he was reviled not again, when he suffered, he threatened not, amen? But committed himself to him that judgeth what? Righteously. Who?
Wow.
Amen? Who? Who is all self bear our sins in his own body on the tree, that we be dead to sin, should live unto righteousness, by whose stripes you are healed. Amen? For ye were as sheep going astray, but are now returned unto the shepherd and bishop of your soul. Amen?
Amen.
In 1 John 3 and 8, it says, he that committeth sin is of the devil. 1 John 2 and 1 says, as a profound declaration, it says, my little children, these things write I unto you, that ye sin not. So the Bible gives us a rundown of sin not. But yet still we continue to hold on to sin. Amen? I believe once we baptize and we make that vow to serve God, amen, we ought to begin to pray, fast, and ask God to begin to change our ways. Amen? But as we hear in John, 1 John 2, it tells us that we ought not to sin. Amen? We praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Now, the Bible also says in Romans 3:23 that all, meaning all of us here tonight,
yes,
all of us who made that vow, amen, have sinned and come short of the glory of God. We praise the Lord. Look at the neighbor and say, I have sinned.
I have sinned.
I have sinned. We praise God. You see, now you say, proud, I have sinned. Because later on, once you drop it, you don't have to say it again. You are no longer proud of saying, I have sinned. Now I am working my way to perfection. We praise God. So I want to go for that and say, listen, Pastor, I have sinned. We praise God. I have sinned. We praise the Lord.
Praise
we have known sin and come short of the glory of God. Amen.
Go on.
The Bible also says, if we say that we have not sinned, we make him a liar. We praise God. And the truth
is not in us.
No one here tonight can deny that you have sinned. Because we all know in our heart that we have sinned. We have made mistakes. You praise God? We all have fallen somewhere along the way.
Well, go on.
Amen?
Amen.
So tonight, all who is under my voice tonight, some of our prophets and some of our fathers of old, we know that they were blessed just like us.
Go on.
And although God has plans for their lives, they fell somewhere along the way. Amen?
Amen.
This week, in the internet, I received an email, which then we were passing it around on Facebook. For those of you who have Facebook, I'm not sure if you saw it, but I saw that it was very interesting, so I'm going to read it to you. It said, Jacob was a cheater. Peter had a temper. David had an affair. Noah got drunk. Jonah ran from God. Paul was a murderer. Amen? Gideon was insecure. Miriam was a gossiper. Martha was a worrier. Thomas was a doubter. Sarah was impatient. Elijah was depressed. Moses stuttered. Zacchaeus was short. Abraham was old. And Lazarus was dead. Amen? We praise God.
Praise the Lord.
I saw it interesting because, you know, as we are thinking about being perfect through the sufficiency of God, these great men and women of the Bible, we praise the Lord. Fell down. They have fought.
Yes.
But guess what? They accomplished what God sent them to do.
Yes.
We praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
You know, we have cheaters, we have liars, we have those that temper. And we, in this house right now, all of us have these particular characters in us. At one point or another in our life, we hit that point. Amen? We cheated, we had temper, we lied, you know, we even murdered. But guess what? These people here got to that goal. They ran the race. Though they had fought in them, they know that the God they served was sufficient to take them to the next level. We praise God. Where are you going and at what level are you found, have you found yourself tonight? Let us retract and search our lives and see where in our lives perfection was not found. We praise God.
Praise the Lord.
Let us begin by letting go of sin. Some people believe that sin is that I killed somebody, I robbed a bank, you know, major sin. Sin is just the thought that I have about you in my mind. So we sin constantly. We continue to be imperfect. We are in the house of God and prayer is going on, yet still our mind begins
wondering.
Perfecting through the sufficiency of God. Amen? So we know that though we are not perfect, we are working towards perfection. Amen? These men of God and women of God work their way towards perfection. Amen? We praise God. Just bear with me because you see, I want to make sure I give you this point of being tangled up and holding on to sin. We praise God. Amen. Because if we continue to do so, we will not be perfected through the sufficiency of God. Amen.
Amen.
We praise God.
The Lord.
So the Bible tells us that if we say that we have not sinned, then we are lying. And the truth is not in us. We already declare that no one here tonight, can say that they have not sinned. Submit and surrender. God, or do you actually keep some back and think that you can handle it yourself? We cannot become perfect that way. But we put it to God, we leave it to God, and we know that He will answer our cry. Amen? He will make us perfect in His sufficiency. Amen? The Bible says, therefore, leaving the principles of the doctrine of Christ, let us go on to perfection. As Hebrews 1, it says also, if any man offend not in word, the same is a perfect man.
Wow.
We praise God. And is able also to brittle the whole body.
Wow.
If any man offend not in word.
Okay,
now. And is able also, that man that offend not, that man is able to bring on his whole body. We praise God.
Yeah.
If you do not offend, and if we look back in our past, and even in our future and our present, we begin to look at that we daily offend our brothers and sisters in Christ. We praise God. Perfection.
Go on.
In the sufficiency of God.
Go on.
The Bible tells us that His grace is sufficient.
Yes.
His grace is sufficient.
Yes.
Amen?
Yes,
the grace of God is sufficient for you and for me.
Yes, God.
Amen?
Yes.
Now, I want to read the Beatitudes to you, because once we hear the law that Moses received in the Old Testament, Jesus Christ came on the scene, and He too has got to say according to the law. Amen? We praise God. And that is in Matthew, the 5th chapter. Amen? And the 3rd verse. And seeing the multitude, He went up into a mountain, and when He was set, His disciples came unto Him, and He opened His mouth and taught them, saying, and children of God, you need to listen to this, because these are the things that we are working in our lives to receive perfection through the sufficiency of God. Amen?
Amen.
Now, it says, blessed are the pure in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Amen? Blessed are they that mourn, for they shall be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they shall inherit the earth. Blessed are they which do hunger and thirst after righteousness, for they shall be filled. Amen? See, there are some things that we will receive. Amen? That thing is to be blessed. Amen? If you follow the instruction, you will be blessed if you do this particular thing. Amen?
Amen.
Blessed are they which do hunger and thirst after righteousness, for they shall be filled. Amen? Those that thirst and hunger and that urge to go after righteousness. That thirst, that feeling to say, listen here, I think some changes need to go on in my life. Amen?
Yeah.
We praise God.
Go on.
You who do so will be filled. It says, blessed are the merciful, for they shall obtain mercy. Amen. Blessed are the peacemakers. Lord Jesus, here we go. Many of us will not be blessed.
Yes.
But some of us do not know the word peace. Amen? We are the fire makers. Amen. We praise God. But the Bible tells us that if we are peacemakers,
yes.
We will receive a title.
Go on.
Only by holding on to be a peacemaker. There shall be a title given to you. Amen?
Yeah.
And it says that you shall be called the children of God.
Amen?
Blessed are they which are persecuted for righteousness' sake.
Amen?
For there is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are they, which are persecuted for righteousness' sake. Some of us will ask. Blessed are ye when men shall revile you and persecute you and shall say all manner of evil against you falsely, for whose sake? Your sake? Your brother's sake? Amen. For God's sake, for his sake, we praise God. It says, rejoice and be exceeding glad. For great is your reward in heaven, for so persecuted they the prophets which were before you. Amen? So these are the guidelines. These are some of the things that we need to follow. Amen? Jesus Christ came back and even made it easier a little later on down. He says, listen here, just love your brother. Your neighbor, as you would love yourself.
Amen?
But can we do so? Some of us don't even know our own blood relatives. But we are seeking perfection. Some of us don't even speak to them for years. But we are seeking perfection. Amen? We are children of God. And we do not follow the guidelines of being perfected in the sufficiency of God. Amen? But he commanded us to follow these things. Go by them and all shall be made well in us. You praise God? I'm going to read you some more scripture. It says, so let us strive to enter in at the straight gate. For many, I say unto you, will seek to enter in and shall not be able. When once the master of the house is risen up and has shut the door, straight is the gate and narrow is the way that leadeth unto life. And few, you heard that? Few, few there be that find it. Whosoever he be of you that forsake not all that he has, he cannot be my disciple. Now let us lay aside every weight. Let us lay aside every weight and the sin that does so easily beset us, and let us run the race with patience. Amen? The race that is set before us, looking unto Jesus. Fight the good fight of faith. Lay hold on eternal life. Watch unto prayer, and then be sober and hope to the end for the grace that shall be brought unto you at the appearing. We pray not at the appearing of Jesus Christ. His grace is sufficient. His grace is sufficient for you. It is sufficient for me. It is sufficient for Pastor Ike. It is sufficient for your brothers, your sisters, your cousins. His grace is sufficient for us. We praise God. The God that we serve is a God that is in us. We praise Him. He's a God all sufficient. He needs no help at all. He is enough in himself, and he is self-sufficient. We praise God. He has everything, and he needs not anything. We praise God. Speaking about sufficiency in God.
and we have enough in Him.
Yes.
We praise God.
Praise the Lord.
In Him.
In Him.
Hallelujah.
Not in you. Not in your name. But we have enough in God.
Amen.
We praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
We have enough in Him to satisfy our most and large desires. He's enough to supply the defect of everything else and to secure to us a happiness for our immortal soul.
Yeah.
We praise God.
Yes, God.
Now, Abraham, at age 90, the Lord appeared unto him.
Amen.
And said, I am the Almighty God. Walk before me and be thou perfect. We praise God.
Praise the Lord.
Walk before me and be thou perfect. And then he said in the second verse, and I will make my covenant between me and thee, I will multiply you exceedingly.
Yes.
At age 90. This happened at age 90. We praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
A covenant was made. An agreement was made with Abraham. Amen.
Amen.
And God.
Yes.
God showing Abraham his what? Sufficiency. Being enough for him amid his situation that he was probably going through. God letting him know, I am sufficient for you.
Amen.
We praise God.
Praise the Lord.
Just walk before me and be perfect while you walk before me. We praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Walk before me. Amen?
Amen.
And be perfect. In other words, he's right behind you, watching every move that you're making. He wants to make sure that you do not go astray. We praise the Lord. Just be perfect in your walking. Work towards perfection. Move towards sufficiency in God. As we become perfect, we realize that God is sufficient for us. But if we continue to hold on to sin, God cannot be sufficient for us. Because if we're holding on to these things, that means we don't believe. Because you see, you have to believe that He is enough for you. We praise God.
Praise the Lord.
When we marry, when we choose our husband and our wife, we believe in our heart that that is the right person for us. So how come when we say I do to Christ, we cannot believe and know that He is sufficient for us? There's enough in God. We do not have to be jealous of Him. One of the books that I was reading, the writer wrote, he said, you know, sometimes when we are talking to God, we have to yell. We have to speak out loud. Because sometimes when we speak too low, though God is sufficient, though He is able to provide for us, there are times when we have to call His attention towards us. This is how sufficient He is, you know. You know, sometimes, even with you in your everyday move, you have children, you have work, you have your home, you have all these daily routines, and somewhere along the way, you forgot somebody. And sometimes they have to call and you have to say, hello. So sometimes we have to raise our hand, wave our hand, give God glory, give Him worship. Just call His attention towards us, call His sufficiency with one another and make us perfect.
Amen.
You see, if we call on God, if we call on Him, and we continue to do so, though sometimes we don't see the change coming. Continue to call him.
Yes.
Continue to hold on to him. Because if you stop, then you will stay away for a long, long period of time. But if you call God's attention with your worship, with your praise, you see, the more you worship, the more perfect you become in Christ. Because worship is the key thing to let go of sin. Worship is the key thing that's going to let you separate yourself from Satan and join the force of Christ. Amen? Some of us want to continue to walk in that road, that big broad road, instead of holding on to the narrow road. Let me tell you something. We have to stay in the narrow way. Hold on to the narrow way. Because that narrow way is where the suffering comes. You see, sometimes when places are narrow, there's nowhere for you to go but to just stay. Sometimes we find some bumps that we try to go over them, but the place is so narrow that we still have to go over the bumps.
That's right.
It doesn't matter what you do to make that change, the bump will be there, and on your way back, that bump is still going to be there. Sufficiency in God. Know that God will remove the bump, and then you are able to walk. But if you continue to shift, you are continue to accept it. How can we be perfected if we continue to run from the little bump? What happens when we get down to the end where there is a cliff? What happens when we get down to the end and there is a hill? What happens when we get down to the end and there is a storm? If we just shift in the small bump. Sufficiency in God. The Bible tells us that we can do all things through Christ who strengthens us. You can only do all things through Him that strengthens you if you walk in perfection. If you walk in His sufficiency. But we continue to try to do things on our own. And then we end up going back to the same situation. Because let me tell you something. Satan does not have new truth. All he do is dress it up. He's dressing up today in pink, and tomorrow he's going to bring it to you in blue. But it's the same form, the same thing. So you have to continue to hold on to God. So that when he comes with his little trick, you know that his sufficiency can let you pass that bump. You praise God?
Lord.
If we realize something, when Jesus Christ finished fasting, it says that the Holy Spirit, the Holy Ghost, took him into the prison. There was a reason for that. He was taken into the wilderness to show us how perfection begins. Tested in his moment of weakness. How many of us in a moment of weakness is tempted and can actually say to Satan, get thee hands behind me? You see, when we moving along in this walk, we have to learn that the Holy Spirit is our guide. And if we continue to refuse it, we are walking like empty vessels all over this earth. Empty vessels cannot communicate with the Spirit of God. Empty vessels cannot reach Christ. Empty vessels cannot be perfected to the sufficiency of God. We continue to move in directions that will take us into being empty vessels. Our friends will be used by the adversary to mess up our mind and confuse us so that we become empty vessels. We praise God. Being perfect through the sufficiency of God. Amen?
Amen.
I said today, God is good. God is an awesome God. There is none like Him. He is the God who is able to perfect my life. I'm telling you right now. If you would have known me a few years back, you would have never think I would have been standing here.
Wow.
It was nowhere in my mind. But through the sufficiency of God, through His grace, you know, through the love that He has shown for me,
man,
I have reached thus far.
Yes.
And I'm just asking Him to help me to hold on to the end of His garment. Amen?
Yes.
Last night, when the youth was here, it was, last night was an awesome night.
Amen.
You missed something good.
Amen.
And one thing that hit me last night when I was sitting here, and I just want to share with you, is that if you notice that the children that the adversary continue to try to grip are the children as pastors, leaders, those of you who are mothers and shepherds and shepherdess and all these things. Notice that our children are the ones who give us a hard time. And while I was sitting there, it hit me, because in the Bible it says that, and this is walking in getting perfect to the sufficiency of God. It hit me that the Bible tells us that the seed, her seed shall beat the head of the
serpent.
That is the seed. It's not me, it's not you, it's our seed. That's going to do the
bruising.
If you saw those children here last night, you look at them and you see the reason why it says the seed. Walking. That's why the Bible tells us that if we cannot rule our home, then how is it we will rule the children of God? It's because the seed, our seed, right? Our seed is going to lose him. And it's already out here, it's in the realm. He knows that it's the seed that's going to come against him. So he has to begin to shut our seed down from an early age. Now watch and see how many of us in our story, in our testimony, will say, you know, because my son giving me a hard time, or my son ended up in jail, or my son was picked up last night, tonight, yesterday, whatever it may be, my daughter, she's pregnant and not married. Because it's the seed. But because Jesus Christ, in His sufficiency, in His perfecting us towards getting to heaven, saw the future. Notice, even if they fall into these various little things, their future is already being perfected to the sufficiency of God. So though they make these mistakes now in their early age, the seed, though make his mistakes and fall in diverse things because they're not strong enough to fight the adversary. They fall into these things. But the seed in the heavenly realm already it is known that that seed is going to be a shepherd. It's already on here to know that that seed has had perfection or perfect her in master. It's going to become a doctor. It's a lawyer. And then in 2030, that seed is a that seed is the one that's going through the head. So of course there's an attack and defeat. Notice when you when we begin to go into the garden and plant certain, there are certain seeds that we will plant that is either the squirrel, the ant, the birds, or one of them will go after it, right? Well, it is the kind of seed that we, the woman, have come carried. I'm speaking about being perfected through the sufficiency of God, our seed.
Yes, Lord.
Our seed will be attacked. Only because there was already a prophecy in the Bible given that the seed would prove the head. So, children of God, I want to say something. As we are being perfected, as we are walking towards perfection, hold the hand of your seed. And let them walk through perfection with you. If they fall, you go. If they get up, you get up. Because it's out. So the attack